Hi everybody, all my followers, welcome to another of my videos. This video today is going to be on a Peugeot 307 BSI. So the BSI, I've done already a lot of the work, but I will take you through everything I've done so far. So this is the BSI. And as you can see, it's from 2001, but this applies to other versions of the same BSI. But please do your research before you attempt to do this, because different versions, they might have different connections on the PCB, so just be careful with that. So this is the BSI. BSI stands for Body Systems Interface, and what we're gonna do here, this BSI has been brought to me to be, I think you say, you pronounce it, virginized or cleared, reset, whatever you might want to call it. But basically what we're doing here is make this BSI as if it was a brand new BSI from factory, ready to be programmed into a car. The BSI is responsible for handling the immobilizer system, and therefore if you take a old BSI or a second-hand BSI and put it on another car, there's two things you need to be very careful. One is the car will not start, because the immobilizer system is not going to be obviously matching the car. Second, the BSI also stores the mileage, and very careful with that, because the mileage on the Peugeot is, on a 307 at least, but most of the Peugeots is the same. And just another note, these BSIs is not just Peugeot, it's Peugeot and Citroën. So bear in mind, applies to both. So yeah, so the mileage is stored on the BSI and on the cluster. So be very careful, because, and just as an example, imagine your car is 50,000 miles and you get a old BSI with 100,000 miles. If you plug this BSI, as it comes from the scrapyard or wherever you get it from, into the car, as soon as you turn the ignition on, the cluster and the BSI, they will adjust both to the highest reading, which means your cluster is going to change its mileage to 100,000. And the only way to get it back then is change both again. So before you actually attempt to reuse one of these BSIs, you have two options. One is you change the mileage before you obviously you reutilize that BSI, and second option is you just do what we're gonna do here. If you just change the mileage, you still have to retrieve the PIN code. But then you'll have another problem, because you can't just change the PIN codes on these BSIs. So the best way really to reutilize one of these is actually do what we're going to do. But I'm going to show you first how to actually get the PIN code. So for example, if your car, if you lost all the keys on your car, or you wanted to reprogram another key, you're going to need that code. And I'm going to show you how to get that code. And then what I'm going to show you is, which is in this case, this has been brought to me just to reset. They want to reutilize this onto another car. I'm going to show you how to actually virginize or reset, whatever, this. So I've done all the connections. I'm going to take you through the connections over there. So you can pause the video if you want. So you need to look on the PCB for those connection points. And my connection points, they are not exactly in the same place. All you need to do is follow the tracks on the PCB and just go to the nearest test point. So like I did here, For example, the reset was supposed to be down here, somewhere there. I've just looked, I've just followed the track, and I went to a better place to do the soldering. And you can do exactly the same. The 5 volt is the same, supposed to be there. I thought it was better to put it on this capacitor, which I did. That one is in the same place. The ground, you have loads of place. But yeah, you can always play a little bit with it. Now, this BSI, in this case, comes with a... the chip on this is a 912 DG128. So it's a Motorola. And as you might know, a MCU is more than that, but it's basically a flash memory and EEPROM in the same chip. There's more to it, don't take me wrong, but I'm not going to go into that sort of detail. Just to let you know, inside that chip, you have the flash, which is the program that runs the BSI, and you have the EEPROM, which contains information like immobilizer code, keys, VIN numbers, ECU settings, and all that stuff. And that's why we want to reset, okay? So I'm going to use CarProc. I have CarProc dismantled because I have to add some units to it because it was nearly running out. So yeah, so this is all connected. All we're going to do now is connect this. And then I have CarProc already opened. Then we're going to read the EEPROM memory. And then I'll take through the rest of the process. Okay, so we are ready to go. So I've, like I said, I've loaded CarProc already. So I've selected the correct MCU in there. And all we're going to do really is just read. So we're going to read the chip. And here he is. So we have the dump now of that EEPROM in there. As you can see. Okay. And we're going to save this. I'm going to save this as... BSI original. It's going to save that. Okay, we don't need CarProc now. So what we need now, where is that one? So is here the file. Now to read the PIN code, there's a few softwares that can do that for you. I'm going to show you just, I'm going to show you two. I'm going to show you this, which is, before you ask which program is this, just read the name over there in the corner. And we're going to do 307. Is a 2002, the 2001, but they are the same, is the same chip. And we're going to open the file, which is going to be, where is that one? It's open. So I've opened the file, I've selected the ECU, the BSI. As I said before, do your research. As you can see, for example, here, it tells me that there's some BSIs that they don't have, they will have a processor, obviously, but the actually memory is EEPROM 95160. So be careful, do your research before you attempt to do this. So that's the one. I'm going to calculate the key now. So it tells me the file size is okay, and it tells me the PIN code of that module. Okay? So I'm just going to show you. So I'm going to close that one. So you can just pause and take notes of that code so you see it's exactly the same. I'm going to open another software. Which one is that one? Yeah, I've done that one as well, which does exactly the same. You might be familiar with this. If not, that's the name. So same thing. So it's a Peugeot. A model, so it's a 307 calculate BSI, so that's the one we want, 307 BSI MCU HC912. That's the one we want. This one even shows me some connections here at the bottom. And we're gonna load the file. And we're gonna start. Same pin code as you can see, but this one actually gives me the VIN number as well. Okay. So, to actually So that's how you retrieve the code. Now, what we're going to do next is virginize, like I said, or reset wherever you want this module. ECU. To do that, I'm going to load the file into this program here. There is two ways to do this. One is you just fill everything with Fs. It should work. I had experience where it didn't. But you can always try. Fill everything with Fs. That will be an empty EEPROM. And then obviously you then need Peugeot Planet to reconfigure the entire ECU. But sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. It's probably to do with the flash versions on the BSI or something like that. So you can do it like that. So you just fill everything with Fs. Or, let me see where I have that one. I don't know. There it is. Or you can use this tool here. Which, what it does is, clears the file for you. So, Peugeot. BS, so. So, BSI 307 2002. It's the one. No, it's not the one. This is telling me is a 95160. Oh, where is that software now? It's not this one. Even I get confused. Let me find the software and then I will be back. Okay, so it was actually this one, but I've done the wrong selection. So you have right at the top, where am I? So this is the software. So you bring it down and you have a few options here for the BSI where you can program a new pin, or you can come down. I've lost it now. Ah, there it is. So 307, and you have the 95160, like I said to you, some BSIs, they come with that chip on it, and you have the HC912. So there is an MCU HC912. So that's the one we want. We're going to open the file now. I've opened the file, so we're going to make this file virgin, and we're going to press repair. Okay, and now we're going to save the file. I'm going to save the same name, but change it to save. Okay, now what we're going to do very quick is we're going to compare the files. So I have both files here. I'm going to open the original file, and now I'm going to open the second file so we can see the difference. As you can see, everything that is highlighted in green is the difference, and you can see it here on the side. Obviously this is the hexadecimal data. But you can see here all the difference. Everything that's green is the difference. Okay. Original at the top, the blank one at the bottom. Okay, as you can see, he didn't fill everything with Fs. There's a few things here at the top he didn't change. He didn't change this bit here, this bit here in the middle. Okay, and he hasn't changed this bit here at the bottom as well. He left the same. Okay. Now what we're gonna do, now just a quick note, if you do have, for example, if you want to clone the ECU, it should work just by dump your file and put it on the next ECU. But sometimes different software versions or flash versions, it doesn't quite work. So you can always try and see what happens. But okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to program that empty file back into the BSI. Okay, and to do that, just open the file. It's the one. Press open. And we press. Hang on a second. So guys, so yeah, so we press this button here. And we're going to program the module again. Press OK. And for you guys that have seen that are paying a lot of attention, you're going to see that the file has changed from when I said I'll be recording and from writing and when I've actually started to write. That's the reason, because the file I'm writing is now the virgin file, because I have the original ECU, and I'm going to try to clone first the ECU. So I'm writing the file that I've actually removed from the original ECU. If that doesn't work, then I have the empty file already. I will try the empty file. So what's showing here is that it does a verification, as you've seen. After writing, it goes back and compares what was written with the file that is here. If everything is okay, it says okay. We press okay, and that's done. So what I'm gonna do now is unplug this and take the wires off, and job done. Hopefully it will work. I don't know if I've missed anything, or if I forgot to mention something, but you have the comments below. Just comment, ask any questions. I'll be more than happy to answer them. Hope you've learned something with this video. Hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said already, questions, comments, please put them below. And like always, thank you for watching.